In this video we take a look to the joystick. The joystick is from itself always centered in the middle, and we have our movement to the left and right, which is the X axis or the horizontal movement, and we have our vertical movement up and down, which is the Y axis. And we have a third thing, and that's this built-in button. So if we press, this iron bar will hit this built-in button, and that's very useful to make a selection. This shows how I connect the wires. On this pin is the ground. This pin is 5 volt. This is the X axis, the Y axis, and the button. Under the hood, inside the joystick, are two potential meters, one for the x-axis and one for the y-axis. If you touch the joystick to the left, then the resistance inside the potential meter will increase or decrease, and that's what the Arduino reads from its input pin. And with those incoming values we can write our software. To test this I wrote a small program, very easy. We set up the inputs X, Y, Z. Z is the button. We set up the monitor, and inside the loop we just print the values of the X, Y and the button. And if the button reads a value of 0, then we print the button is pressed and delay for 1 second. I will put a link to this code below the video. So you'll see that if I do not touch the joystick, the incoming values are around 500. If I switch the stick to the left, you see the X value is dropping. And if I put it to the right, you see that it's building up to 1012. If I put it up, you see the value going up all the way to 1000. And if I put it down, you see it's dropping to 0 or 1. And if I press the button, you see it prints value is 0. And it delays for 1 second. And then it prints another line. To make it a little bit more exciting, I connect our LCD screen on the board. This is how it's connect. And this thing is a potentiometer. And if you turn the potentiometer, the light of the LCD screen will fade or glow up. This is the type of the LCD. This is a very common one. You can buy it almost everywhere. And this is the joystick. Inside the code, we include a library for the LCD. If you don't know how to include a library, watch the video over here. We set up the pins for the LCD, and inside the setup we write a character to the screen. And inside the loop we write to the serial monitor all the behaviors we have from the X, Y button, which line we are, if something changed, and a counter. And if we scroll to the left, the voltage will drop. This is a built-in function from the library, and it will move to the left. And if the X is higher than 650, it will move the character to the right. And almost the same happened on the Y axis. If it's higher than 650 and it's on line 2, we go to line 1. We clear the screen and we rewrite it on the next line. And we do the same with the button. If we press the button, we clear the screen and we rewrite it with another character. On top, I define 2 characters. So we start with this one. And if you press the button, it changed to help. And it changed this boolean to false. And if you press again, it clears the screen again. And it rewrites it back to the old character. This is all the incoming data from the monitor. We write down the X value, the Y value, the button, on which line we are, which character, and on which place we are in the counter. And if I switch the joystick, you see that we go to the left, and we go down, and if we press, we get another value, help.
And if you press again, we have our old character back.
And you can see in the monitor that over here we pressed it and over here. And it changed it from 1 to 0. And this is about the joystick. I will put the code below the video. Thanks for watching. In the future I will make a more detailed video about LCD screens. Hope you like it. Please subscribe and see you next time.